Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a quick look at the relightning tool in DaVinci Resolve 18.5 public beta. And it's just a super quick video where I kind of show you how to set it up so you can start playing around with this new tool. So it is kind of clever. So without further ado, let's get right to it. Okay, so here we are in the color page of DaVinci Resolve 18.5, and we're going to have a look at the relight. So we're going to use this clip here as an example, but I am just going to go up to my LUTs gallery, and I'm just going to add in a Blackmagic LUT here. So we'll put this in some kind of a nice place. This was also shot on the Pocket 4K in RAW, so just to keep that in mind. And of course, we are going to take our clip here. And for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to actually take the gain and put that down a bit. I'm going to make this a little darker scene, something like that. Maybe I'll take the gamma a little bit down, something like that. Okay. And then I'm going to go to my grid here, and I'm going to right click on the note, and I'm going to add in a note, and then going to add in a new serial note, and I'm going to do that one more time, because to do this effect I will need to have two extra notes. So I'm just going to take my second note here and put that down below here, because that's going to help me out a little bit. And then I'll go up here to search for a tool. I'm just going to search re, and I have my relight here. So I'm going to add the relight to the second note and to the third note. So as you saw, when I added the effect, we got in a new bunch of in and outputs, and we are going to use those for our effect here. So first up, we're going to take the green output here from our medium, and I'm going to put that into the green input here at the third note. Then I'm going to take my green output here and put that to this input here. And in the second note, I'll go into the inspector. And in the inspector, I'm going to click this check mark right here. And then I'll go to the third note. And up here, I'll go to surface map. And I'm going to change that into use input 2. And then I'm just going to toggle this relight map preview off. So there you go. If nothing happens, it's because you are not on the effects layer. And you can change that down here. But I was on the open effects layer. So if you are not using that, you are not going to see anything, or you can't change anything. For instance, things like brightness and stuff won't work. Okay, so let's get right to it. I have this tool here, and I can move that around just for you to be able to see. I'll go into the gain here, and I'm going to pump up the gain. There we go. And I'll also go into the gamma, and maybe I want to bump that up as well. So it works pretty simple. As you can see right here, we have the tool. It's doing this in real time. It's super fast. The way it works is, if I move this up, I'm going to move my light source higher up, so I can, for instance, you can see, have it here, move it around like that. It's pretty powerful. There is some different options as well. Right now we are at a point source. We can also go to directional, and then we can kind of change things around again like that. If we want to do something really dramatic, we could do something like this, the dramatic shot. Again, super powerful. We also have a spotlight, and that can of course be moved, and we can take this, put that on a face and make it larger and stuff like that, put it here, and then we can move the spotlight around, stuff like that. So it's super powerful. I'll go back to point source, and we have, of course, here our light properties. We can go into the brightness, and we can actually control that here as well. So we can bump it up. We can, I'll just move this light a little closer here to the face. Perhaps I'll also just move it down a little bit like that. So let's see, maybe we want it to be a little more dramatic like that. We have the brightness here, of course, in the inspector, and I can then, you know, take it down or up and figure out where I want it. Also, I could control that down here in the color wheels as well. We have a reach. You can see here that's going to do a little here. Let's say we're going to bump that here, and we have a contrast, so we can also make it very contrasty. So if we wanted to make it a little more dramatic, we would do something like that. To make a little more dramatic lighting, we can do that. So there's a lot of possibilities with this tool, and I'm not even scratching the surface. This video is mainly made just to get you started to mess around with the different settings. So anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.